Hello everyone, I would like to make this video to help you in getting your project done for the moon elongation. So let's first of all see how we get there. You go on a homepage at the bottom where it says projects. Another way to get there is also of course through the module, because the projects are part of modules. But by going straight to the modules, it will ask you to scroll down on a paper, and going on a home page and just clicking on a project take you straight there. Let's open a project. And so I'm asking you to start observing the moon. I moved the date a little bit on September 13th, which is this coming Sunday. And I moved the due date a little bit more. I made it on October 31st, just to cover the time that we lost during the shut off and I couldn't communicate with you this week. Alright, so first of all, if you download the project right here, let's do that. It will open and you will have 35 observation days that you have to do. You want to start a little bit earlier, just so you have time to finish up. And in this particular video, I'm going to teach you how to do the calculation, although everything is given to you here step by step as well. So for that reason, I picked what is an angular separation. It's nothing else but the angle between the sun and the moon observed from Earth. So that kind of gives you what is the illumination created by the sun on the moon. And that creates what? The moon phases that you already learned about it. Now, for every 1 minute in the sky, it's calculated in degrees, a degree between the two celestial bodies as 0.25. For every 1 hour in the sky is 15 degrees. How do we get these hours and times and whatnot? You get them by seeing the difference in time between the sunrise and the moonrise in that day. Well, where do we get these times? Well, I put here a link, and when you click on that link, this opens up. And today I'm going to stick with the example from September 11, and we're going to do the calculation of today. And one thing here I want to mention is that, for example, today the moon rises at 12:18 in the morning. That means you're not going to stay until midnight to observe the moon. So if that happens, just kind of use the pictures that they give you. But, and of course, not only that, but there will be days like now when it's so thick, the smoke, you're not going to be able to see the moon either. So use the drawing here. They actually even give you the waning crescent. That's part of the moon phase. And let's go back to our document. One thing I also gave you is in order to do the graph. So they said it's a waning crescent, I believe, right? Yeah, waning crescent. So that will be a kind of a 7, but I want you to pay attention between last quarter and waning 7, right? So this is what is a 50% illumination. This here looks like a 25% illumination. Yours here was what, 30 some percent illumination. So sometimes the numbers are in between. So you don't have to use exactly these numbers. What if it's illumination somewhere in between here? Then your number will be a 5.5 in a table. That is for us to be able to graph it. So let's take an example. I'm going to start with an easier example. So I'm going to assume a day of the calendar that the sun rises at 6:20 in the morning and the moon rises at 10:50 p.m. That's like a more like a normal behavior, I would say, for about at least half of the months, right? Because it goes all the way around to 360 degrees. So now we want to calculate the difference between the sun and the moonrise. How do we do that? Well, you look at the clock and you do your calculations, but I want to kind of give you an idea. From 6:20 in the morning until 7 in the morning, they are 40 minutes. From 7 in the morning until 10 at night, and by the way, you can use the military time as well, they are 15 hours. And then from 10 p.m. or 22 until 22:50 or 10:50 p.m., there's another 50 minutes. Then you add your minutes together, right? So that's 90 minutes. And then you copy how many hours you had. So that's 15 hours plus 90 minutes. 90 minutes is an hour and a half. So that gives you a total of 16.5 hours. Or you can leave it 16 hours and 30 minutes. Now remember, for every 1 hour in the sky, 15 degrees. For every 1 minute, 0.25 of a degree. So the total angle of separation is your 16 times the 15 degrees, right? Plus 30 minutes times 0.25. You put in a calculator and you get 247.5. Or if you have a exact decimal here, right, 16.5 times 15, that gives you the same number. So now, because I just made an assumption, let's assume that this 247.5, if I am looking at the document that we had, let's see, can I find it again here? Here you go, right? If I look at the moon phases, and here's 0 degrees, 90, 180, 135, and so on, 225. So if I am looking here, so 135 is, by the way, if you measure the other way, but if you go 45, 90, 135, 180, 225, here's 270. So the 247 is somewhere here. So I'm assuming that my moon will be somewhere between waning gibbous and third quarter. So between waning gibbous and third quarter, I'm looking right here, waning gibbous and third quarter or last quarter, it's going to be between 5 and 6. So normally it will be a 5.5, right? However, for my assumptions here, it didn't matter. I just picked a number. I said, well, go and graph it at 7. That means you're going to look at your graph and where you see 7 or 5.5, for example, and you go at your find your angle in degrees and you draw your point. You're going to do that for all 30 days. Now let's go to the calculations for today. Yeah, because this is a little bit unique. So you have 6:44 a.m. to 12:18 a.m. So there's two ways to do it. You go around the circle one way, and you either find the big angle or the little angle. It doesn't matter, all right? It depends. It's kind of like looking at the clock. You either consider from that morning until the next night, past the midnight, or you go in at night between the 12:18 a.m. and 6:44 a.m. So let's do the long way first. From 6:44 in the morning until 7 in the morning, you have 16 minutes. From 7 in the morning until midnight, you have 17 hours. From midnight until 12:18, you have 18 minutes. You add them all up and you get 17 hours and 34 minutes. Now to do the angle calculation, remember, for every 1 hour in the sky is 15 degrees. So hence 17 times 15 plus, for every minute in the sky, it's 0.25 degrees, so 34 times 0.25. So that gives you 263.5. And remember, if you go around, 263 will be somewhere here, right? Now, if you want to do it the other way, whatever you get, your hours here, you can get the new hours by subtracting from 24 hours, or you can simply redo the calculation. So 12:18 a.m. to 6:44 a.m., from 12:18 a.m. until 1 a.m., 42 minutes. 1 a.m. to 6 a.m., 5 hours. 6 a.m. to 6:44, another 44 minutes. You add them all together and you get 6 hours and 26 minutes. Look, if you add 6 hours and 26 minutes with 17:34, you get 24 hours. Now, if you input the same rule here to calculate the angle, you get 96.5. Meaning that if you add these two, you better get 360. Either one of those you have to put in your table, not both, but one. Good, now that you have this, you need to graph it, right? So the way you're gonna graph that, a graph was provided for you on page 3. So here you're gonna go and find your angle and find the moon phase and do your point. By the time you are done, you're gonna get 35 points almost in a linear way. They are not necessarily gonna be perfect, but they don't have to. But they will be somewhat in a linear direction. Don't forget to do your prediction and what phase of the moon will be in the last day of the semester. So make sure you identify, maybe pick the day of your final as the last day of the semester, right? Because that is actually for this particular course. Put the date here and put the prediction of the moon based on a graph, right? You're going to figure that one out. So the prediction will be whatever it will be. Put the phase of the moon and the number. And then you fill out a table. I kind of give you another example. This is an older example from 2018, but the same idea, how you calculate it and then you graph it. One other thing I want to point out to you is that you have an example of work for a moon elongation of a student that actually got 100%. If you do a good job like this particular example, you will be able to get 100%. I covered the name of the student, but here's how the graph looked like. And because we have 35 points, there will be 5 days that they will overlap, right? The moon already did 1 month, so we have few days that they will point out to overlap, 5 or 6 days. she did the prediction and then the table, and all the work was filled out very nicely and correct, not only nice. Okay, rubric. The rubric is long, you can read it, but to see a short version of it, you may click here. And let's open it and look at it together. And so on the rubric, I'm going to observe, okay, if all the days were completed, all 35 days on a table, I'm going to spot check 5 days for correctness. Literally, I'm going to look at every detail, and those 5 days will be worth 25 points. The graph completion, at least all 30 points have to be there, if not all 35. And the prediction for the date request is 5 points, and the quality of your graph and the drawings, 5 points. All right, the longer version is here. Feel free to read it, please. I think I covered everything. Now, the last thing is when you submit this paper or this bunch of papers in Canvas, please use the Adobe Scan. Adobe Scan allows you to take all those pictures and convert them into one document. So please don't turn me in 7 pages because it's very hard to grade. There will be, you know, I have to switch the pages all the time. One document only. And please turn in only pages 3 through 7. Also, not to forget, I have on the homepage, if you want to have access to this particular class notes that we just talked, remember they are in a Google Drive. How do you get there? You go right here, it says class notes. When you click on class notes, this is automatically hooked up to my Google Drive. It will ask you here, hey, can I request permission? Put whatever email you want. If you have a Gmail, that's fine. Since I don't know your Gmail accounts, you guys have to ask permission. And then you're gonna find this document into the class notes right here under the Moon Elongation Project Help. Well, I hope this does it, and it will help you to turn in a good project. Okay, thank you so much.